Perth lockdown is being felt in Sydney tonight. Incoming travellers ordered into the same strict isolation conditions. Late this afternoon, WA recorded a new COVID case linked to the growing hotel quarantine cluster. Fresh vaccine concerns too, with three more blood clot cases.
They flew out of Perth as the city went into lockdown, arriving in Sydney to health workers in masks, gloves and gowns. Those on the first flight in from the west today also facing questions about possible exposure to the nation's latest outbreak.
Which terminal we flew into and where we were.
It's very confusing actually. I've just finished. Nothing was said to us in WA.
Required to declare if they'd been to one of Perth's COVID hotspots, which meant an immediate test and self-isolation for everyone else.
Well, they've just told us to isolate for 3 days, and get tested if there are symptoms.
Carolyn was meant to fly from Perth to Adelaide today. With the lockdown instead, the plan to just get home.
I think it's a very long, long road until we're back to normal.
It's extremely important that we make every effort to avoid the introduction of the virus into the local community.
They're back in Sydney but still have to follow WA's restrictions. If the lockdown is extended for Perth, it is for them too here on the other side of the country.
Queensland ordered return travellers into 14 days quarantine as of midnight. The rule changed when Adrian's delayed flight was mid-air.
And a decision that just seemed sort of ludicrous because if the plane had left on time, we would have been there.
As Perth's lockdown took effect, city streets and freeways were deserted. Day one has seen big queues at COVID testing centres and late this afternoon, a new case.
But if we can all work together and do the right thing over the next few days, we'll increase our chances of stopping the virus in its tracks.
Authorities identifying hundreds of potential contacts with a man infected at a quarantine hotel by travellers from India and a friend he saw once released. The three-day lockdown cancelling Anzac Day events. WA's Premier says with hotels not fit for quarantining, he's demanded the Commonwealth do more.
I suspect all the states are getting pretty heartily sick of it, that they have these facilities that are available and they refuse to use them. So we're saying to the Commonwealth, it's time they step up.
The federal government insists its facilities, defence bases and immigration centres just aren't suitable. But no Commonwealth official was talking today on confirmation of three more cases of blood clots linked to the AstraZeneca vaccine, including a 35-year-old woman from New South Wales. That's now six cases so far, including the first person over 50.
Well, they should be speaking out every single day to build confidence that they're going to get this job right.
With the growing number of COVID cases here from India, calls for a travel ban.
People going to India at the moment from Australia just has to stop.
The country's hospitals overwhelmed of new daily cases. Here, tankers full of oxygen are rushed to hospitals to deal with demand as the death toll rises. Paul Caddack, 7 News.